In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up the PayPal Standard Upsell plugin. So the first step is to log into your PayPal account and get the API info. When you log into your PayPal account, go to Profile and then you click on My Selling Tools. You will notice API Access and there is an update next to it. Click on the update next to it and you will see it will bring up a page like this where we are interested in the option number 2. That says Request API Credentials. Now, if you have done this before, then you are going to see a View API Signature. But if this is the very first time you're doing it, you're going to see a Request API Signature here. When you click on the Request API Signature, it's going to bring up a page like this, where it's going to say API Credentials consists of three elements: username, password, and signature. You can go ahead and select the default option, which is Request API Signature. Agree and submit, and it will generate the username, password, and signature. And you can copy that to a notepad, and we will need to insert that in DApp setup config section. But if you have already done this, then when you go to the API access page, option 2, instead of request, you will see a view. You can just click on the view, and it will show you your existing username, password, and signature. Make a copy of that, make a note of that, and you will need to insert that in DApp setup config section. In the next video, we are going to see how to insert that in DApp. In this video, I'm going to show you how to enter the PayPal API info that you got from your PayPal account in DApp setup config section. Please log into your DApp admin panel and then go to setup config page. On this page, if you keep going down, you will notice there is a payment processing PayPal section. Now that's a section we are interested in. Items 7 through 10. So these are the four text boxes we need to fill up. The API username, password, signature, you just need to copy whatever you got from PayPal for these three right here in these text boxes. The API endpoint is already set up and you don't have to change it. If you want to connect this to your Sandbox account, then all you have to do is change the API endpoint to sandbox.paypal and that's it. Otherwise, just leave the default and it will work. Now, if you want to connect to Sandbox, one more thing you have to do is change the Use PayPal Sandbox to Yes. So if it was set to No, make sure that you set it to Yes. But all this only if you want to use Sandbox. And after you're done with the Sandbox testing, remember to switch back to No and also switch back the API endpoint to this address. Now that's it as far as the DApp config setup is concerned. Now let's take a look at the next steps.